Hey, what's up? It is Michael here. Today, I'm going to take a look at a little experiment that I wanted to try that would allow me to do things with Logic Apps and with social media posting. Let's go ahead and let's talk a tiny bit more about the problem at hand. I use software that is called Streamlabs OBS, and that takes care of my stream. And I also use another piece of software that is called Stream Deck. So on my other machine, I think I have it installed here. So this isn't the profile that I currently use. What I'm currently doing is that I have one PC that's running Windows 10 that handles all of my streaming stuff. And then I have this other Mac that I primarily do a lot of my other type of work on. So I've kind of separated out the stream to where my main PC is not taking, it's not taking too much of a processing power hit. And so one of the things that I wanted to do is that whenever I start a stream, currently, it walks through this process, which is right here. It's in Twitter, and I'm going to double click on this, and you'll see that it does things such as changes your name to over here. Here's the tweet that goes out. I'm live now on Twitch talking Azure App Dev and more. Come hang out with me and we'll learn together. Once I start the stream, I want to do things such as I want to change the name, my profile name, and you can see it kind of up here. I want to change the name to put the little recorded emoji and then say live now. And then I've got a delay set just in case it needs it. And then the next step is Twitter tweet. And so this tweets the stream out to my followers. I'd like for this to also post out to LinkedIn. LinkedIn is not like a built-in connector here. So for example, if I do like Twitter, you know, you could see the things like such as like tweet, change name, all that type of stuff's already available. Also, since the software in and of itself, it doesn't allow you to even add an account for that. So I'm gonna come back to Stream Deck. Let's minimize this other window here. And so if I go to Stream Deck and I even look at the different types of accounts, so I'm gonna click down on this. I'm gonna click add an account. I do not want that. If I tried to add an account here, and again, I'm trying to post. I'm gonna go over here to properties, and I'm gonna go to properties in this window, and now I'm gonna hit done. Oh, and by the way, Rainbow Ren 10 has joined us. Hey, Ren. What's up? So what I was doing just a second ago was that I am looking for a way to be able to use Stream Deck to automatically post out to Twitter and also to LinkedIn. So the current issue is that it only currently works with Twitter and these services underneath here. Mixer, Streamlabs, Twitch, Twitter, YouTube. That's okay. What we're gonna do is I'm gonna try to add in that functionality, and I'm gonna try to do that using the great and the wonderful Azure Logic Apps. I'm going to close out of this, and this we'll leave open because what I'd like to do is I'd like to put like another step in here, and there is like a browse. Yeah, there's like this website task. And this website task is going to be what we're going to want to use here. Let's go ahead and close out of this. And let's go into Azure. I'm going to go portal.azure.com. Just set a marker. What I'm currently doing is we're going to use Logic Apps to post out to LinkedIn whenever we go live. Okay, Ren, the first thing that we're going to need is we're going to need a resource group. And you can think of a resource group as something that holds, or it's kind of like this container of all of the different types of services that we're going to put inside of it, like app service or Logic Apps, etc. So I'm going to go in here and I'm going to pick one of my subscriptions. I will actually put this, since it is something I'm just playing with, in this other account, which is my enterprise account. This is the free money that I get per week. So I'm going to go into Stream Deck. Right now it's set to Central US. We're going to go to West US and we're going to go review and create. I'm going to hit create. Perfect. So now what we have is we actually have our resource group that we're going to add stuff inside of it. So I'm going to scroll down and I am going to go to, there we go, Stream Deck RG. I've got a resource group that's already been built out. Now I need to actually fill it with a Logic App. In order to do that, I am going to simply go add. And what do you think I would search for right here, Ren?
Add Logic App. Yep, that is correct.
Logic app,
and I'm gonna go create here. So what I am doing here is I am trying to use Stream Deck to update my LinkedIn status. Currently, Stream Deck does not support that, so I thought I would just use Logic App since it's super fast. What I've done so far is we have an HTTP post schema that's in here. We started creating our own kind of like schema tool. Currently doing is I am going to clean up the JSON schema a bit, and we're going to have two fields. One we're just going to use for LinkedIn. We may add this in another episode. And then the other one is going to be called, I don't know, for example, like Twitter. And we're just going to have these as two values. So it can be a value of 1 or 0. 1 means active and that you should tweet about it. And 1 is active and you should tweet about it. And 0 would be like no. So I'm going to grab this JSON and I'm going to come back over to my Logic App Designer. And I'm just going to use a sample payload here. So LinkedIn, Twitter, we can hit done here. And what it did was it just went ahead and it put together the JSON schema. So you can see we've got an object and it's expecting two properties called LinkedIn integer, Twitter integer. If we go down here to create a different parameter, we're going to click on method. Inside of method, this is going to be a, let's see if we can just back out, a method here, and we're going to use a get. So basically we're gonna call this URL that it generates, and I don't need a response to come back. So this is, for example, if you wanted to send something back to you. You could do that. I don't need that. So that's going to be the request coming in. And I'm just going to go ahead and hit save. And hopefully this saves properly. And it looks like it did. And then we're going to have a status code of 200, which it gave us this one completely by default. So you can think of 200 means it basically was successful. You could have a bunch of other status codes, like a status code of 400. If you had a status code of 400, well, that means it was a bad request. If I save this right now, and I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to copy this URL out of here. If we run this URL, we can see that it just returned successful. The reason that just returned successful is because that's what we typed in to our body. So now I would like to go back in here, click insert. We're going to add an action. This is where I think the power of some of the Logic App stuff really shines through. So I could now type in like LinkedIn. And there's two versions of the LinkedIn API. There's a LinkedIn version 1, and then there is another LinkedIn, like a V2. The only reason I know about this is that I actually found the bug when LinkedIn first switched over to V2. Linked. Okay, that's the one that we're going to want. We're going to want LinkedIn V2. And what we want to do is we want to share an article. We're going to need to sign in before it will let us do that. It has been a really long time since I actually did this or logged in. I've been logged in for so long on my own machine, it's kind of crazy. What we want to do is we want to share out our stream. So I'm just going to go https://. We're going to go twitch.tv. We're going to give mbcrump. Obviously, we want this to be available, visible to guest or not. We definitely want that to be visible to guest. So for the title, we're going to want the title and we're going to want the description, at least for right now. So title of the content being shared. So before I was using Stream Deck and it had some of the content that I wanted. So I'm gonna go back to configure Stream Deck and I'm gonna copy some of this. What I want it to do is I want it to say title. Title is I'm live now. I'm live now, and I think I need a space right here. I'm live now. And actually I'm gonna make this one a little bit more specific and I'm just gonna say I'm live now from Twitch. The description of the content being shared is where I'm gonna go back in here. Oops, wrong one. Don't want that. I do want this one again, configure, go here. What I'm gonna do is I'm going to copy most of this, all of this text really. Do a control C here. And this is the description. So I'm gonna be, you know, I typically do like, you know, hey folks. We're gonna go, hey folks, I'm live now. I'm live now on Twitch talking Azure app development more. Come and hang out with me and maybe my daughter. Ask questions and we'll learn together. That's kind of my style. We ask questions and then we just learn everything together. So I think that's really like it. Let's save this. And we already have the URL over here. Let's go ahead and log in to LinkedIn. So I should be able to hit this URL and it should actually post it for me. Okay, it did come back saying successful again. So it did tweet it out. I'm live now on Twitch, but it really didn't put that description in there like we wanted. So let's take this post and let's go ahead and delete it. Once I delete it, I'm going to come back over to this and let's see if there was another parameter that was here. Title, description, text of the share. Well, maybe I wanted this. So I'm going to save this, and now that I've saved this one, I'm going to come back over here and let's go ahead and see if this works. So we know that at least the API calls, it returns, you know, successful. By using Logic Apps, I was able to pretty quickly get this up and running. Server did not receive a response. So sometimes it does that, the LinkedIn API kicks back if you're calling it too frequent. And I don't know what the frequency is. So let's go back over here. I'm gonna see myself in a browser, seeing myself with an image of myself. That was pretty easy. So now I've got a URL. And what I'll probably wind up doing is I'll probably wind up taking this URL and regenerating the SAS tokens. Because now I could come back over here into, go back into this configure stream deck. We're gonna clear that out. We're gonna go back up. Actually, we could go right here. We could just we're just testing it. I could do browser or web. Web's up. You know, probably would want to have a delay in here. So let me go ahead and let's drop a delay. We're gonna put the delay right there. Delay is a second. And now we have the ability that we can access this URL completely in the background using this multiple task, which is pretty cool and it's pretty simple. You saw my Stream Deck that's running over here on the Mac, which I'm not using that setup at all anymore. But over on my other main machine, I'm going to use this same URL. So I'm going to go here and I'm going to go into delay. Basically, I'm just recopying and pasting all of this information to another URL. I'm going to put in the delay and I'm about to put in the website. I'm just going back and getting that URL. Remember that URL has a SAS token. You don't want that to leak out because that means anybody could call this API. And so you can also regenerate those tokens, which I may show you in just a second. So I'm going to go back in, go back into our Logic Apps. Sorry, you can't see what I'm doing right now at the moment. And I am going to now go back in and grab that HTTP. So I've finally got the URL. I'm going back to website. I'm creating the website over here on the other machine. Can't show history. Okay, so this is Stream Deck. And by the way, I don't know what was necessarily the best way. This is just me kind of playing around, at least for the moment. And I'm also gonna grab website here. This is going to be linked. And let's see how well this actually works. I'm going to close this one. I'm going to come back here and I'm pretty sure that there is some sort of limits. I know you can't do the same exact thing. So I will need to delete that. I'm going to refresh my history. Once I refresh my history, okay, so it shows that. So now I have created that button. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to press that button. Okay, I did. I put it to access in the background. Put it in the background. So let's go to Stream Deck, access in background. Maybe I can't access it that way. So I'm going to try another way. Ah, I'm getting that limit, those rate limits again. Because if I go back over here to the designer, you should be able to see that it has failed a couple of times here. If you look at the status, content is a duplicate of another URN that was shared. So we could actually fix this very quickly by coming into the message and tweaking it a bit. Again, I'm going to keep the access in background. So if we come back over to our Logic Apps and we go to LinkedIn Updater and we go to the designer mode. I'm live now on Twitch, hey folks. Let's just change this one little bit here to and more. Let's save this. So now we'll have a totally different message. LinkedIn's API does, it sometimes takes a little while for it to be updated and completely cleared out of the queue, even though that status isn't there anymore. Before the API will return, it's not duplicate content. I think you gotta wait like a day or so. So let's try it again. I'm hitting the button on my Stream Deck called LinkedIn Updater. It's gonna basically hit this API. There it succeeded, so now we should be able to see it. That was pretty cool, and that was pretty fast. Since the Stream Deck did not have a way to configure an account for LinkedIn, since all that it supported was, and I don't need that, all that it supported was Mixer, Streamlabs, Twitch, Twitter, and YouTube, I also wanted to post to LinkedIn. So I was able to do that simply by going to Azure, creating a resource group. Once I created the resource group, I used a Logic app and I did a when an HTTP request is received. This is for maybe some future use. Right now, I put in LinkedIn's expecting an integer, and then Twitter's obviously expecting an integer as well. And the method here was just simply a get. So that means when you hit the URL, we need to get a response. And this one came with it. I kind of used this template. So status code 200, everything went perfect, everything went fine. Here, the body just says successful. And then I used one of the connectors. So there is a ton of different connectors that's out there. And so what I did was I clicked LinkedIn V2. I gave it the URL. I want it to be visible to everybody. I gave it a title and a little bit of text here. After I saved this, this right here is the get URL. So I was able to copy that get URL over into my Stream Deck configuration as just simply a website. I pasted in the URL that came from my Azure Logic app, and then I just selected access and background, and now I'm able to update my status to LinkedIn whenever I get online. That was actually pretty cool. I do appreciate those for kind of hanging out with me. If anybody's got any questions, I'll hang around for a minute or two, but that is primarily what I wanted to